It is time to make some bread and butter pickles. Y'all, I have to tell you, I never liked bread and butter pickles. Never ever liked bread and butter pickles until I made my own. And once I made my own, oh my gosh, I love bread and butter pickles, but I still only like my bread and butter pickles. What are you snorting at?
Nothing.
The fact that the macaroni and cheese and peas are here that are going to be going with the supper that I'm making in a few minutes. Okay, so in here I have 2 1/4 cups of plain old white sugar. My plan is to make 4 quarts. It could make up to 6 quarts. Not quarts, pints. Pints of pickles, pints. Bread and butter pickles, I just can't see making quarts. Some people would eat a quart at a time. We don't eat a quart at a time, but we do eat a pint at a time. 1 1/4 cups of white vinegar and 1 cup of apple cider vinegar. Apple cider vinegar gives it just the right flavor, I'm telling you. Then I have all of my spices. Now, there's one thing I'm gonna do. I have my sterilized jars, rings and lids in the bottom of my broiler pan in the oven with an inch deep of water, keeping everything sterile, keeping everything hot, because we're gonna hot pack this and then we're gonna stick it in my pressure cooker and do a 10 minute water bath. So I use calcium chloride pellets in all of my pickles because it helps keep them crispy. Of course, bread and butter pickles aren't that crispy, but the calcium chloride helps just a little bit. The other thing I do is I put a single allspice berry in the bottom of each jar. But I also, in my mix, have 2 allspice berries. I'm gonna have 1/8 teaspoon of ground allspice. Here's all of my yummy yummies. 1/8 teaspoon of ground allspice, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, and 1/2 teaspoon of red pepper flakes. I have 1 teaspoon of celery seed, 1 teaspoon of ground cloves, and 1 tablespoon of mustard seeds. Put all of those lovely, lovely spices in there. I took 2.5 to 3 pounds of cucumbers straight out of my backyard. Abby, that's not the one you should be showing. This one was an accidental one. It got missed. So it's actually still edible.
Huge.
Yeah, it's just really big. So anyway, I took 2.5 pounds of onion, or not onions, 2.5 pounds of cucumbers, 3 pounds maybe, out of my backyard, sliced them about 1/4 inch thick, and added 2 yellow onions. And then I added to that about 1/4 cup of pickling salt, and I mixed it all in together really good, and I put a weight on it and stuck it in the fridge for at least 3 hours. You can do it overnight if you want, but 3 hours minimum, because you want that to weep and you want those flavors to start melding a little bit. Did you get in my video? Mr. Eats My Food All the Time.
Hey, I can't blame you, that's too good.
Oh, it's too good. That's his excuse. So, Anyway, mix all that together. Let it sit in the fridge for 3 hours overnight if you need to. And then rinsed all of the salt off of that. And I've been letting that drain for a little while. So I'm going to put this on the stove. And then once I've got all the sugar completely melted and it's nice and bubbling, I'll show you the next step. So, my spices are bubbling. My little mixture here is all nice and blended together. My sugar is melted. My liquids are going at it. So I'm gonna stick my lovely cucumbers and onions in here together. Get this all in here so that it's, there we go. Well, I was gonna do that anyway, but it was overflowing the top. So don't giggle at me, Abigail. Now, I need to bring this back up to a boiling temperature
without
breaking my spoon. I've got just enough liquid that it's going to cover everything. It's just going to take it a minute for this to boil down and get everything covered. So once I've got this all covered and got every bit of it heated up and boiling. We'll be back to show you how to pack this and get it ready to go into your jars and into the pressure cooker for the hot water bath. See you soon.
Fun time, y'all. My mixture is bubbling here.
Again,
yes. This time with the cucumbers and pickles together. We're gonna hot pack this. What that means is I just took these jars straight out of the oven and I'm putting as much as I can into the jars. And so you don't have to watch me fill 6 jars. I'm gonna do a couple of them and put the lids on and then put them in the water so you can see. And I'll explain what happens with the boiling water bath. The beautiful thing about pickles is because they're so acidic, you don't have to pressure can them. You can just put the lid on them and let them go for about 10 minutes, as long as you've got steam rising up out of the lid of your pressure cooker. So you want to pack these until they are about 1/4 inch from the top full. And the beautiful thing about the bread and butter pickles is you can put a lot in these. But you can't have just the cucumbers and onions, right? We gotta have some juice. So I'm gonna stick this down in here, fill it with some of that beautiful juice and some of those spices. And it's really only taking a little over, maybe 3/4 cup of the mixture to get that up to where I want it. One thing you gotta be really, really careful about when you're making pickles and stuff, dry your lids and dry the top of your container, because you do not want this stuff leaking or busting open. So my lid is dry, my container is dry. Ring doesn't have to be dry, although I'm going to get that seed off of there. There we go. Tighten that up. You don't have to tighten it all the way. Take it out. Drop it in the hot water. You want your hot water, once you get all your jars in there, to come up to 1 inch above your jar. I only put 1 in there so the water only rose a little bit. When I get done, it will have risen enough. So see y'all when these are done. I don't know if you can see that or not, but
there's steam coming out of there, which means this is ready to roll. So I'm gonna set my timer for 10 minutes.
And then shortly after that, I will take them out and let them set to make themselves into some really good bread and butter pickles.
Y'all, look how those are already starting to turn colors. 10 minutes in that hot water, they're starting to seal. I don't know if any of them are going to pop yet. That's my favorite. You hear that? It'll do that and stay there when it's cool enough. And that means that these are preserved and they will stay that way for 1 year, 2 years. The best part is the longer they sit, the better they taste. Although we could open a jar tomorrow and eat them up. We'll let them sit for a little while because we've got some leftovers from the last time I canned a bunch. So, if you're ambitious, try this recipe. Let me know how it turns out for you, and y'all take care.